Hi everyone, it's Sam from SiteMate. In this video, we're going to look at how we can use the lists section to manage a list of subcontractors inside of Dashpivot. Now, it's really good to have a centralized source of truth for your list of subcontractors that you can then refer to in multiple templates or in multiple places within the same template. But you can also use the list section to manage certain details about each of your subcontractors, such as their contact details, insurances, when those insurances expire, and things like that. So I want to show you how we can manage all of those details. So here you can see we've got the list already. If we click on it, this one has already been populated with a bunch of subcontractors. So on the left-hand side, we can see all the list items are the names of all of the subcontractors. And then we have a couple of columns for the different properties. And we only have three property columns so far. You can add more if you'd like. But in this example, we have a column for the insurances. And this is what we call an attachment property. So you can see here, we actually have a PDF attachment of the insurances. We can open that up. We can download it. We can remove it. Over time, as the years go by, if you need to renew some of these insurances, you can upload more than one attachment. So the list section basically becomes the source of truth for all of these documents for each of your subcontractors. What else is handy is that you can have a property called a date expiry, and it's a date field, but it's color-coded depending on the date that you input. So if the date is more than 7 days away, then it shows up in green. But if it's within the next 7 days, like this one here, you can see it comes up in orange. And if it's overdue, then it comes up in red. And so with this simple sort of traffic light system, makes it really easy to see which insurances have expired or are about to expire. And in addition to that, you can actually configure some automatic notifications to go to a specific person within your team when that date is approaching. So if you want to get notified 30 days before that date occurs, you would select this box. If you wanted it once it's overdue or a day before it's due, you just select the right box and then select the right person who you'd like to automatically email and then click the update button. So that's really handy. That helps people avoid getting caught out with expired insurances. And then we have a simple column here for just the phone contact, and that's just a text property. Now, this is a really simple list setup. In your case, you might have other details for the contact person, the contact address, and so on and so forth. You might have different columns for the different types of insurances and so on. So there's a lot that you can do here. It's very easy to just add additional properties, just give it a name. So maybe this could just be the address, and then we select the type of property. So you can just add additional columns for the different properties, and away you go. You can then populate those details for each of the subcontractors. Now, a last couple of notes in this video. So this list, once you've set it up, can be referenced in all of your different templates that you have set up. The flow-on benefit here is that if you're using a standardized list like this, then in your analytics section, you'd be able to analyze your data based on these list items here. So in the case of subcontractors, if you had a simple daily report where you were tracking how many hours each subcontractor was working each day, you could use your analytics chart to track the number of hours that each subcontractor had worked over the course of a month or a quarter or a year or over the span of an entire project. And it's really easy for your teams to use because it's just a simple drop-down menu where they can select which subcontractor and then populate the hours and so on. We do have a separate video that covers that in the analytics overview video, so feel free to check that out. One last thing about setting up lists. If you have a list of all of your subcontractors, either in an Excel file or in Google Sheets or a separate software, if you want to export that as a CSV file, that can actually be imported into Dashpivot and save you a heap of time when it comes to setting up that list. So you just export from another system a CSV file, upload that here, and it will populate all the items. And then from there, you can then add in as many properties as you'd like. And that's how you can manage a list of subcontractors using Dashpivot. Feel free to check out our other videos in the tutorial section covering off different use cases and other videos that cover the different features that we have here in Dashpivot. If you get stuck or have a question, feel free to reach out to our team just via the live chat on the Dashpivot website. The live chat is also available in the app. So I hope that this video has been useful, and thanks for watching.